Hey guys, welcome back. So I hope you enjoyed your weekend just past. I had a really quiet one, so that's always nice. I enjoy just a nice quiet weekend at home. It's my favorite thing. I have some new release things that I wanted to haul for you, and apply them as I go along so you can see. And this is the look that's been created with the products. So I've got some new releases from Chanel, YSL, Bobbi Brown, Estée Lauder, and more. I hope you enjoyed this video. Keep watching, and I will speak to you soon. Bye. I'm going to start with this, and this is the Sheer Foundation by Burberry, and it's a really nice, glowy foundation. It's got medium coverage, you can build on it, and it really just makes the skin look healthy, luminous, and fresh. I'm going to apply the foundation with the Tom Ford foundation brush. It's a lovely brush to apply any cream or liquid. I will say this foundation color in summer is a tad bit too light for me, but we are in winter, so. So I've just done one half of my face so you can see it gives great coverage, luminous finish, just how I like it. Just going to apply a little bit of my NARS Radiant Cream Concealer, and this is in the shade Light One Chantilly. It's a tiny bit lighter than my skin, and I like that just for a bit of brightening. So I just go in and do this kind of triangle, bring it out here, and just drag it down. A little down the center there, around the nose, anywhere where there might be a little bit of redness. This is a great concealer for the daytime because it looks quite natural and it gives a really nice amount of coverage. I usually like to let my concealer set on my skin before I start blending it in. That way it'll be easier to blend in with less effort. So I'm just going to go back in with my Tom Ford foundation brush and literally dab that in. So now you can see it's brightened up the skin just through the center of the face. This is one of the new products that I'm excited to try, and it's the Vita Lumiere Compact Douceur by Chanel, and it's in the number 10 beige. Probably going to be a little bit difficult for you to see it, see the color, but it is quite light, but it's very neutral. So it's got a little bit of yellow, a little bit of pink in there. So I'm going to apply it with a new brush. I'm going to apply it with the Chanel powder brush. And the lady at the Chanel counter recommended this one. So I've had this one years ago and I passed it on to a friend. and this is the number one powder brush. I've always liked this brush. It's really nice, it's dense, and it's a really nice, unique shape. So I'm just gonna tap it in. This powder is beautiful. It gives a nice coverage. It doesn't look powdery or dry on the skin. It's a very nice satin kind of finish. So once I'm done patting the powder in, I just lightly dust any excess off the skin. I'm just going to do a little bit of bronzer to warm up the skin. This is the Burberry Warm Glow Bronzer in the shade number 4, Summer Glow. So it's a very kind of terracotta red color, which mimics the look of a almost sun-kissed skin. So I'm just going to use the Tom Ford bronzer brush, and I'm not really contouring or anything, just warming up the back of the face. Always brush a little bit through the temples and the forehead. I'm just going to contour the jaw. I was so excited to share this one with you because it is just gorgeous, and it is the Cindy Luminizer by The Balm. That's their new luminizing product to die for, you guys. So I definitely recommend you guys try this one if you haven't. It's beautiful. It gives this gorgeous apricot sort of glow, and it's just stunning. And I'm using my favorite Bobbi Brown powder brush to do this. I really love that, and it's just such a good price point too. So it is just gorgeous. I don't know if you can see how stunning that is. Okay, so I have two new blushes to show you, but I think I'm just going to try on one. So I've got one of the new Bobbi Brown blush releases, and I've got one of the YSL Kiss and Blush Lip and Cheek Creams. So the Lip and Cheek Cream I got is in the shade 1, Fuchsia, and this one was sold out quite quickly, but I managed to pick one up, David Jones. So I think this would just be stunning on the cheeks. I'm not sure if I would use it on the lips. Really nice, bright fuchsia. So I'm going to go on with this, and this is the new Bobbi Brown blush. I believe they released a few blush colours. New shades, and this is in the shade Pretty Coral. It is a really vibrant, almost flamingo type pink. Translates quite nicely on the cheeks. I think I'm really in love with this colour. So that is Pretty Coral, number 31. Go check it out. It's stunning. Okay, so I'm going to move on to eyes. I've got two new Chanel shadows that were released for the fall. I've got Hesitation and Palpitation. They were the two shades that stood out to me the most. Absolutely stunning. Love them. So I'm going to apply these two, and I'm going to incorporate another palette that I got, the new YSL Couture palette, and this is in the shade number 9. So I had to get this one because I love my pinks and my plums, and this is just absolutely stunning. So I'm going to incorporate this one in with the Chanel shadows. Using the applicator provider, I'm going to start with this very light warm pink here. I'm going to apply that all over the eyelid. I'm just going to create quite a simple look to test these out. See how we go. So they apply beautifully, especially using the applicator. I love using the applicator when you're applying light color on the lid. So you can see that's quite a nice, almost peachy style pink. think I'll go in with Palpitation, just a light wash through the crease. You can see it's a really unique rosy brown pink, just beautiful color. I'm going to use my NARS number 12 crease brush. I'm just going to lightly run that through the crease, very lightly. This is going to be like my transition type color. So I'm just dusting it back and forth. So beautiful, you guys. This is the sort of color that really just brings out, you know, blue, green eyes. Taking Hesitation with a more detailed crease brush. It's a beautiful, unique color. It's a plummy, burgundy brown. And I'm going to use my old NARS number 12 brush. You can see it's got more of a tapered tip, because I'm going to dip this in and take it precisely through the crease. I'm literally now just going to push it in and go back and forward. Because I've got quite hooded eyes, I think this is quite a nice way of creating a little bit of a deep set effect. Let me know if you guys got these, any of these eyeshadows, and if you think I missed out on one that I must have, because I mean, they're all beautiful, they really are. So you can see now that's created quite a lot of definition in my eye. You can see my eyeball is like popping almost. Because I've got the lighter color on the lid and the deep color in right in the crease. I want to take another color from here. I might go in with that really nice center plummy color. It's just stunning. So might just add that in the crease as well. I'll use the applicator because I might actually do like a bit of a wing with the eyeshadow. Quite precise here. I want to keep, definitely want to keep that color off the eyelid. I'm going to take a clean crease brush and just lightly blend it out. I want to keep the sharp wing here. Just pull it out just a little bit. These eyeshadows are beautiful so far. They just go on so beautifully, they blend out lovely, just no effort whatsoever. So I'm going to take this cool lilac pink shade and apply just a little bit to the center of the lid, and I'm just going to use my finger to dab that. I'm just going to run the Chanel Hesitation on the lash line. I'm just going to join it up with the eyeshadow. There's literally little to no fallout there, so that's really good eyeshadows. Don't think I'll do a winged liner today. I might just run a little bit of this eyeshadow along the upper lash line. Just for a very soft look, and this is the Kira Ways eyeshadow, and this is in the shade Onyx, which is a beautiful black. So show you the packaging. It's just a gorgeous. And then you slide it open like that. You can see it's a really nice black shade. I'm going to take the MAC 214 brush. I'm literally just going to dab this color on the lash line. Literally just pushing it in. So you can see it's not too heavy, it's not too much. This is supposed to be a natural makeup line, this Kira Weiss line. It's quite expensive, but I have read some reviews and the quality seems to be quite up there. I will say the quality of this eyeshadow is quite up there too. This is just my NARS eyelash curler. Just line my waterline with this nude eyeliner by Rimmel. Okay, so very excited to try this. This is the Dior Overkill mascara, which won the Nobel Peace Prize. So the exact name is Dior Show Iconic Overkill Mascara, and this is in the shade black, I believe. Noir, yeah, over black. I'll just show you the wand. So it's a contoured wand. If you guys love this mascara, let me know. If it's your favorite, let me know, because wins some great awards, this one. So far, I really like it. Easy to apply. It's actually quite a dry mascara, which is what I love. So most of the time I have to wait for my mascaras to dry out before I start using them. I really do not like a wet mascara. I can see it's thickened the lashes a little bit and it's lengthened them a lot, but it's really quite nice. So that is a big thumbs up so far. I might actually have to buy full size of that soon. It gives quite a similar effect to the Bobbi Brown Smoky lash mascara, which I love. Just going to go ahead and fill in my eyebrows and I will be right back. Okay, so I've got three newer lip shades to try. These are all new releases. I've got the Gloss Volupt number 49, Estee Lauder Lip Lacquer in Rose Vinyl, new Bobbi Brown lipstick color in Tulip. So Bobbi Brown did release some new lipstick colors as well recently. So very excited. I'm going to try all three on for you. So starting with the lightest, going on to the darkest. So we'll do the Estee Lauder Rose Vinyl. I do have Peach Glass, which is my absolute favourite. I think it's one of the most stunning colours, peachy colours you can get. So this is Rose Vinyl. It's quite a beige light pink. And I'm not going to use any lip liner because I want to see the colour on its own. I like this one because it's got quite a nice tip. You can get precise around the edges of the lips. So you can create the shape first. And I must say again, stunning colour. I really do adore these because they last a long time. They stay glossy, like really juicy, glossy all day, and they wear off quite nicely. So there is the swatch of rose vinyl. So I'll just take that off and take the swatch off, and let's try the Gloss Volupt. So this is in the shade Fuchsia, Terre Bleuement Fuchsia, or can't pronounce it because I haven't really read properly what the name is, but it's number 49 and it is a stunning bright purple fuchsia. And I initially saw this on the Luxe Babes channel. I'll link her below. She's absolutely a gorgeous girl. Isn't it beautiful? And let's do a bit of a swatch here. It's not a very good swatch, is it? Probably see it on the lips better. Beautiful colour. Gives off a lot of colour, as you can see. It's just stunning. It's a little bit gritty, just a little bit. So it's quite glossy. It's nice. It's got the classic YSL scent. Quite fruity. Let's try Tulip. It's just a really pretty, maybe rosy Huntington Whiteley sort of shade. It's really gorgeous. Richly pigmented. Very richly pigmented. Really beautiful color. It's actually not really a rosy Huntington Whiteley color. It's kind of reminiscent, but it's beautiful. So love it. The texture of it is really, it's rich, it's opaque, it goes on beautifully. I like this much better than the matte lip colors by Bobbi Brown. I really don't like the texture of those lipsticks. They're too thick and too, it's almost like putting a really heavy stick concealer on the lips. Love this color. So that is everything I had to share with you today. I hope you enjoyed that and you got some nice ideas. Definitely try some of these products. I think they're absolutely outstanding. And let me know which one was your favorite lip color. I think I like this one and number two, number 49, I should say, the YSL Gloss Volupt. So I hope you enjoy the rest of your week. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. I wanted to thank you all for your support. Thank you for all my new subscribers, all my old loyal subscribers. It means a lot to me. And I hope my channel continues to grow and get good feedback. And I will speak to you soon. Enjoy your week. Bye.